Hey guys, Spirit of the Law here. Age of Empires units sometimes get a bad rap for their pathfinding and odd quirks, but with one specific behavior, they're incredibly brilliant. In this video, we're going to look at how they pick which enemy unit they're going to target next. Not only is it a good idea to know how your units behave so you know when they can make their own decisions and when you need to step in, but by the end of this, I think you'll also have a bit more appreciation for how smart your units really are. To start with, a basic fact is that all else equal, units attack whichever enemy unit is closest to them. Here we give our blue champion a choice between two red champions. Every time, he'll go for the closer one first. This is pretty common knowledge. Let's reset though, and this time I'll pause and set him on aggressive stance and attack move towards the right. He takes a quick step forward and then checks to see which is closer. In this case, the one on the left was slightly closer at that moment, so he still went for that one. Obviously, momentum and direction aren't a factor. It's all about distance. That's a pretty simple rule, but what if two units are exactly the same distance away? How does a unit decide between them? Here I have four units all equally distant, and you might think it's completely random. Actually, so did I going into this, but every time he goes for the one at the top. For whatever reason, he just doesn't seem to like that guy. If I take that unit away, then instead he always goes for the one to the left. So obviously, units prefer to attack in certain directions when all else is equal, right? Actually, no. What's really determining this is the order that I place the units before the test. Here I have three identical setups with equally distanced units, but I change the order I place them. The ones I circled are the oldest of the red units that I placed first, and when I set my units to attack stance, you can see that's the unit they target. Personally, I don't think this kind of age discrimination has a place in the game, but we have to remember the 90s were a very different time. Now, if units like preying on the old, maybe they also like preying on the weak. Here I have a unit that I placed down first, so it's older, and the other unit has some damage that I've added to it already. Which will the blue unit pick? It turns out it's the one with the lower HP. If I put the damage on the other unit, then he targets that one first. It's pretty smart, as I wouldn't want all my units chasing the enemy with the lowest HP at the same time, but all else being equal, I would want them to finish off a damaged unit rather than attack one at full health. To expand on it further, here I've made the left unit take a lot of damage, but artificially raised its HP, so it's at 162 out of 570. The other unit is generic, but at full health. Will my champion prefer the lower percentage or the lower total? It turns out he prefers the lower total HP, and again, he's taking out the unit that'll go down the fastest. In my mind, that's the right call. So far, he's pretty smart, but let's try to trick him. The unit on the left now has 162 HP left, and the one on the right has 70, but I gave it a ton of melee armor, so he'll take longer to bring down. Now which will the blue champion go after? Again, to my surprise, he picks the target that's faster to bring down, even though it has more HP. Again, this is some pretty solid logic. Let's give him a tougher problem though, and see if he can take everything into account. The oldest unit here has a very low 70 HP, but enough armor it would take 24 hits for him to take out. The next one has 308 HP, which means it would take 22 hits. The next one has 220, but because it's on a hill, it takes 25% less damage. So in this case, it would take 21 hits. And finally, we're going to make a unit that has 280 HP. So more health, but without a hill, it only takes 20 hits to take out. Ideally, he should attack this one first. If I set him on attack stance, he does in fact go for the weakest enemy. Let's remove that one and try it again. Now he should go for the one on the hill, and you can see he does that correctly, so 2 for 2 so far. Just to make sure he's really thinking about the hill, I adjusted the hill unit's HP to the same as the one on flat ground. Now he should attack the one on flat ground instead, if he's aware of the hill bonus, and that's exactly what he does, so this is really taking everything into account. Down to the last two, again no surprise, he goes for the unit that takes 22 hits instead of 24. I can swap their places and it doesn't matter how many times I do it. I tried each of these multiple times and he didn't make a single mistake, despite having a lot to consider with armor, HP, and a hill bonus. I also played around with adding attack and taking away attack to the different units, but that didn't seem to affect anything. Now let's see if the units can also take bonus damage into account. Does the champion know, for example, that it has a +8 attack modifier against eagles? If he doesn't, he'll see the champion here goes down in 5 hits, and the Eagle Scout will go down in 6. On the other hand, if he knows about his bonus damage, then he'll know the Eagle actually goes down in 4. And of course he knows about it. He's a smart guy, and he even knows how to calculate that with hill bonus damage thrown in there as well. It also can't be that units are programmed to fight their counters, because if we buff the Eagle's HP, the champion avoids it. He'll look at the other three champions equally distant and fight the one that's the oldest, progressing around the square, attacking the next closest unit. Notice at the end, he doesn't avoid the Eagle Scout this time, because at that point, it's now the closest. Just to be clear, this doesn't overwrite the most basic rule of units targeting the closest enemy first. Even if a unit only has 1 HP, if it's just a fraction of a tile further away, then the champion will still go for the closer one. This is all just a very intelligent tiebreaker mechanic. In case you're wondering, we also see the same sort of thing against ranged units. They're generally lower HP, but if I buff the crossbow's HP so it takes more hits than the champion, then my unit goes for that one first. In case you're wondering, villagers don't get any sort of special treatment in this calculation. On the other hand, unit size is a factor. Champions have a relatively small radius, whereas elephants are much larger. You can see the champion prefers the elephant, so larger units like cavalry and siege are going to pull nearby units toward themselves more often. At the same time though, if we push those units back a bit more, then the champion won't go extra far to reach them. Now this has all been between different units, but we should probably take a quick look at buildings as well. Just to mix things up, I have a couple of different units here. The champion and crossbow are closer to a building, and the ram is closer to an enemy unit. But of course they instead choose to fight against their specialty. The ram heads for the closest building, and my units engage the closest enemy unit. Now that may not be behavior that you always necessarily want. If you patrol into the middle of an enemy town, they'll start by attacking all the units and villagers, which is fine, and they'll then start working on the town center. But every unit that walks by causes them to disengage and chase it around. What can end up happening is you're just left with a nearly destroyed town center that's never quite finished off because your units chase the villagers that jumped out of it at the end. In that case, you can help them out by targeting the building directly. Notice in that example, they seem to really like the town center, and it's true that units don't treat all buildings equally. Town centers work like a bit of a magnet, and both rams and non-siege units prefer town centers to things like houses. You also see the same behavior when it comes to things like castles and towers as well. Other buildings like barracks really don't seem to get any sort of special attention. Interestingly, they'll even pick town centers and castles over wonders, so if the game is on the line, target those directly and don't just leave it to patrol or your unit's decision making. Now one final thing I wanted to look into is an old description of the samurai. I can't remember if it was an in-game tech tree description or in a manual, but I remember something official saying samurai seek out the strongest enemy units on the battlefield, or something to that effect, as if it was an actual game mechanic implying they try to attack stronger units preferentially. I've always wondered if that was true when enemies were equally distant. Here I'll give some samurai a bit of a choice. We have the lowly spearman, another samurai, and the Teutonic Knight. Obviously, the Teutonic Knight is the strongest, and if I let them go, they actually target the samurai, which at first seems promising, as champions will always prefer the spearmen here. That is, until you remember samurai take out other samurai in 2.2 hits, because of their plus 10 bonus damage against unique units. For the spearmen, they take them out in 2.8, so they're still going for the weakest unit from their perspective, and the original line about seeking out the strongest opponents was probably just a reference to their bonus damage against unique units. So there it is, and while it may not seem chivalrous, units definitely have a preference for attacking the old and the weak. Most of the time, of course, they'll have a closest enemy unit and the choice is made for them. But as we've seen, when you have equally distant options, it becomes way more complicated than just picking one at random. That's all for this one though. Big thanks to Jean-Paul, Samantha, Ben, Brian, James, Kyle, Noah, Ilik Toes at Night, and everyone else on Patreon for their awesome support. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.